It's the holiday season, so it's time to break out some festive movies and analyze them past the point of no return. From Rudolph to It's a Wonderful Life, nothing is off limits. So put some Christmas lights on your tinfoil hat and let's get into some of the wildest holiday movie controversies you might not have heard of. I'm Anna Rumor and this is Pop Culture Social Call. Let's kick this off with Die Hard, and we're gonna start with this one because the controversy is it actually a Christmas movie? Now, John McClane in an air duct feels festive to me, and the whole terrorist plot goes down at a Christmas party on Christmas Eve, but is that enough to declare it a Christmas movie? Now, people feel very strongly about this one, so I'm gonna go with a bold take. If you want it to be a Christmas movie, it is. If not, that's cool. Not even It's a Wonderful Life is safe from controversy. Now, this next one's way more obscure. I actually never heard of it until this year, but did you know that the classic holiday movie was initially considered communist propaganda by the FBI for a decade after its release in 1946? Now, why? Doesn't the FBI have other things to do? Well, no, apparently not. Mr. Potter is the bad guy in the movie, and he's a banker, so old FBI memos note that discrediting bankers is a common communist propaganda tool. But didn't they forget that George Bailey is also a banker in the movie and he's the good guy? Now, I like this one because it makes me imagine an old-timey FBI agent just watching this movie with his family, arms crossed, like, nope. Let's move on to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, the touching story of a reindeer whose nose helped save Christmas, or a relentless story of bullying, depending on who you are watching it. Now, obviously, we know Rudolph was excluded by the other reindeer from the reindeer games because he was different. That's the whole setup to the movie. He's a cute little guy. It's sad, but is it controversial? Well, some people argue it's not exactly a happy ending that Rudolph gets friends once they realize he's useful. And when you think about it that way, it is kind of bleak. Also, what was Santa doing this whole time? Does his naughty nice radar not extend to like 50 feet away from his house? Now Santa's on my naughty list. Watch out, Santa. Home Alone faced similar criticism. Kevin is clearly being bullied by his older siblings and the adults in this movie. Now, this one I will defend as important to the movie, because do you think parents who are super attentive to their child's emotional needs are going to forget him at home? And do you think a child who isn't being tormented is gonna be so stoked that his family disappeared? Also, where do you think he got all those booby trap skills from? That's self-defense, baby. Kevin McAllister, forged in steel by his family's horribleness. I bet you thought Frosty the Snowman was unproblematic. Well, think again. How cold could it be if these animated children are wearing shorts and skirts throughout the whole movie? Okay, that's really all I have to say about that one. That one's more funny than controversial. Do you know any other holiday movie controversies? Drop them in the comments and hit subscribe while you're there. Then head over to popculture.com for the latest in entertainment news. Until next time, I'm Anna Rumor, and this is Pop Culture Social Call.